Hey everybody, this is Kim. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show how to make an Americano espresso drink on my new espresso setup that I have in my my home. Now, I have a Facebook page called Moonbucks Coffee Bar, which is what that came out of this, basically. And this is in my house. I recently decided to upgrade all of my equipment. So what you're seeing here is some of my new equipment. I have a new grinder by a company called Eureka. That grinder is called the Specialita. And then next to it is my new espresso maker by ECM. They're a German company. Machine's made in Heidelberg, Germany. I think it's designed in Italy, but it's German built. So anyway, what you're seeing here is me preparing the system to make the coffee. I've already ground the coffee beans, which I got locally from a Flint roaster. Called Fireside Roasters. The name of the coffee is Flint Strong, which if you live in Flint, you know that's a saying that we have here in Flint with all the things that's gone wrong in the last couple of years that made us newsworthy for everybody. So we now have our own bold espresso bean roast called Flint Strong. So here I'm tamping it down, getting it ready to make in the espresso maker. Tamping is a black art when it comes to making espresso. Man, I've thrown away more bags of coffee that I tamped so poorly that it either didn't barely come out of the machine, or it was so runny that it didn't taste very good. So there's a real art to getting the grind set properly, the dose, that's the amount of coffee that you put in the basket after you've ground it, and then of course how hard you tamp it. And then if you watch the gauge on the machine here, it's going to go up to 9 bars of pressure, and that's about what you want to get good extraction from your espresso beans. You'll see they start to turn a caramel color here in a minute, and that's crema. That's kind of what you want. That's the deliciousness of the roasted bean that you're extracting with the hot water. There's a lot going on here, I know. It's a lot of work to make a cup of coffee, granted. It's like, I can see why people have Nespresso machines and Keurigs for sure. But in honesty, it's a lot of fun to do, especially if you like to drink coffee and you like good tasting coffee. It also has a frothing wand where I could steam milk to make a latte or a cappuccino. And that in itself is a whole other art form that I have yet to master. I can definitely make good microphone foam to make a latte or a cappuccino, but I can't do the art. You just got to spend a lot of time doing that. And right now, I'm just trying to get the coffee part of it down so I have good, delicious tasting coffee without a lot of milk in it. Those videos, as I explore those and get better at it, I'll certainly put up on the YouTube channel. But there you go. And that's a high quality Americano right there. It tasted great, by the way, just to let you know. So feel free to leave any comments below. Like my channel, please. Subscribe if you want. I also do a series of videos on what I call Tiny Garage, where I work on my BMW motorcycles. Those are also intermixed in here as well. So take care. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day.